Good morning and a very, very warm welcome to all my fellow panelists. And it's actually a surreal conference. I mean, each of us sitting in wherever we are, glued onto the screen. And I think, but for COVID, I don't know whether Corporate India or India Inc. would have accepted this reality. And the fact is, I think if I were to look at each of your entrepreneurial journey, which has been very, very fascinating, I think it's also a time in Indian history that I want to bring to attention. Entrepreneurship has never been celebrated much more than it is celebrated today. I think if we look back a generation, let's say 30 years ago, entrepreneurship was not seen as a very, very highly commendable job, if I can use that word. It was not seen as a great option unless you are from a business family. The only way that was seen as an honorable one was that you go to school, you go to college, get a degree, get some job. 50 years ago, it was a government job, then it became a corporate job. And what has happened when I see a look back 25 years of my corporate career, when I joined Corporate India, it was like you joined a company and stayed for life. And each of you run fantastic ventures where I think if somebody stays with you for more than 2 years, you might even celebrate you. HR might bring a cake. And that's what I want to pick on to start off. Very interesting point about visiting card. A generation ago, visiting card was almost seen as a ritual. And it was also a way of showing off where your office is. And it was almost like a social identity that you went and you sat in a desk and a chair and a cubicle. I'm sure you've seen the fights for cubicles and cabins because somebody got promoted and didn't get it. And let's cut to the chase. Remote working today. Work from home, work from anywhere, work from boyfriend, girlfriend's house, work from an auto rickshaw, work from the airport. How has life changed for each of you in your ventures? And I would like to do a quick round robin from starting with, let's say, Abhishek Deshpande, if you can start off.
Sure, Srinath. So the new normal was very exciting, rather I will say, because we were not expecting something like will happen in our lifetime. And all of a sudden, things happened. Yes, a lot of positive stuff happened, but a lot of challenges also happened. People were used to complain that they are not able to spend quality time with the family, which started happening that they're able to spend quality time with the family. I always wanted my team members, being a startup entrepreneur, to be a multitasker. I was always giving those pep talk that we have to be multitasker and all. Spend a lot of time on that. The funny thing happened is that never happened, but when this started, work from home, that started, my team members become multitasker, not at the work. They are holding kid in one hand, mop in one hand, and on the call. So that kind of multitasking started happening. Fun apart, but when we talk about a business, a lot of good things happened with us also, because not to all the verticals, for the sales and business development per se, the productivity has increased because we were traveling out of 30 days, 20 days, we are always on our airport, going to Mumbai, going to Delhi for the meetings, and we are able to do only two meetings in a day. In this lockdown, the sales started performing so well that we started doing five meetings in a day. We are able to close 50 new enterprise clients in just 2-3 months. And my sales team started saying that we need a lockdown every year because we are more productive in this time. So such good initiatives are happening, but same time, there are a lot of challenges are happening. I believe that's my strength because I observe the every team member. So the body language helps me a lot to actually interact, to judge how that team member is performing. Even though somebody is with the body language, I can tell you that there is some challenge with his work or some personal life. So I used to take him aside or for a tea or for a break. I used to discuss a lot of things with him and used to motivate him. Nowadays, I'm struggling because I'm not getting that opportunity. I'm not able to judge the people. I'm not able to understand what's going on, why they're not able to perform, because I'm not able to see their body language. This is the major challenge nowadays I'm facing. For a startup entrepreneur, this is going to be more challenging because for the tech giants, this is easy because there are a lot of SOPs and there is a very well-structured environment, so they can actually they're like task one, task two, task three. So they can actually work in such work from home environment. But when the startup entrepreneurs, they have an agile kind of work environment, they really don't know what is going to happen tomorrow or the next week. So a lot of innovation needs to be done. I feel the this is new normal is good, some part, but when it comes to the innovation or a brainstorming sessions and all, which is like a core of spine of the startup ecosystem, which the startup entrepreneurs or people like me are struggling because that innovation is not happening much, that brainstorming is not much productive. So I feel personally the new normal is going to be different. I feel this is going to be a physical kind of concept. Future of work is going to be a physical. It is not going to be complete virtual, complete digital. You have to work on a physical model where you have to be a physical, doing physical also things and digitally also things. It has to be a combination of physical and digital. Few verticals can definitely perform better, like technology and all, but there are a lot of operational things which need to go physical. So I'm looking at the future of the work and one is going to be a complete digital. That's my take on it. Thank you.
Sure. Thank you, Abhishek. Going to Aditya. Aditya, what if you had to add on? Do you see any difference or do you see any concerns in what else can be done?
Yeah. So of course, you know, everything has two sides, and I definitely like something and miss something. I love the fact that, you know, I'm not jet setting for a 1 hour meeting to different cities, and I can catch up with the team at any point in time. I miss holidays. You know, there is nothing called an off, I think, now, you know, because I know as an entrepreneur, you're working 7 days, but you want that weekend off at some point in time. You know, one very important thing I miss is serendipity. I read about this, you know, when Steve Jobs built the Pixar office, the office was made in a way that people interact with each other no matter what teams they're a part of. And I think the best of ideas in the last 3 years have just come from coffee conversations or just catching someone outside over a walk. I definitely miss that a lot. So I think these are the two sides to it. Yeah, as a person who's handling sales, I am much happier not being at the airport here. I don't miss that.
Okay, thanks. Moving to Nikhil. Nikhil, I mean, one of the constant ones that we've heard is, we've always used the word saying, I'm busy with conf calls, I'm busy with meetings, I'm going to be traveling. And now I think almost it's like the open secret of all the entrepreneurs are known to their families and friends. Even the kids can figure out that is it what you actually do for a living. So, and especially your business being in co-living space, give us some tidbits or trivia that has made your journey very, very interesting. Are there any tweaks that you'll see that you'd have to bring in from each of your offices?
So I think what we realized is we can save a lot of money by not having city offices. So we have 10 cities, and we had big offices in each city. And due to cost pressures, we had to sort of cut down there. And we realized we have so many properties, we actually don't need offices. Like we have average 30, 40 properties each city, and in Bangalore, we have 150 properties. So we just figured out a way to work out our properties, and that's like almost 15 lakhs a month. I mean, cost aside, but the bigger benefit, there have been pros and cons both. So the con is that ability to monitor, ability to sort of put accountability, especially on the junior talent, is much tougher. With senior guys, it doesn't matter where they are, where they work from. And anyway, you're not going to monitor them. You're not going to ask them to like basic efficiency questions. But we are struggling a lot on our junior talent. Some people have gone back home where half of the time the problem is mera idea ka network nahi aata. And I don't know who to curse. Idea, you, why did you get idea? Why didn't you get Jio or try something? God knows what. So it's a mixed bag. For senior talent, consistently what I've heard, the senior leadership, they have become more effective because travel time is saved. And respect for timing of the con call is much higher because everybody knows that he'll be getting bored staring at the camera, so people generally show up on time. In-person meeting, if there are three people chit-chatting, the fourth guy has no guilt. He shows up 10 minutes late. And this is a consistent pattern that we've observed, that meetings generally start on time, end on time. That itself is a great efficiency parameter. So the goods and bads across the board. Regarding home, our home is team because my wife is my co-founder. I mean, earlier co-founder, then my wife. So our home was always half office, half home. It's today also half office, half home. So at home, nothing much has changed other than we keep conflicting on our con calls. Like I walk into a room where she's having a con call and she walks into a room where I'm having a con call. Other than our con call fighting and specificity of, so this spot has the best internet. So I had to just throw her away that get off, I have a webinar. I need this best internet spot. So that's I think home and office in terms of what we are observing and what we've realized. In terms of business, one unique thing that is happening is that people are now asking for work from home options or a work from home infra in co-living spaces. So we are sort of enabling that. And we are also creating micro working spaces. Like earlier, what was only a dining space, now we are putting better kind of chairs, lounge and lighting that it doubles up not only as dining space, but also as a working space. We are adding a couple of small cabins here and there for con calls so that people are not fighting with each other on con calls. So there are changes which are happening. But in the long run, I believe that mankind will return back to human contact. No matter what we do, this is a hard coding of 100,000 years. Just 6 months of COVID cannot take it away. We crave human contact. We crave looking into someone's eyes, like Abhishek said, body language. And right now we are eating out of our own seed corn because we had built those relationships over last couple of years and this whatever time frame sort of we were able to capitalize on that social capital. But if this continues forever, then every employee is literally gonna be employee. He's never gonna feel like an owner. He's never gonna feel like that I belong to this organization. Ek packet aata hai, email mein packet mein kaam karke wapas bhej deta hu. That's not how great organizations are built. So people will have to come together. They will have to collaborate. They will have to fight, shout, scream at each other about their conviction and their ideas. They will have to get disappointed and someone will have to hold their hand and say ki koi baat nahi hota yaar, agli baar teri maan lenge. And these things have to happen for a great organizational culture to sustain. The benefit that we're experiencing is our social capital of last 5 years. But it cannot be forever. I strongly believe that within 6 to 12 months time, as the fear of COVID goes back, we'll more or less be back to our habits. Although these con calls and webinars will remain. Because now this is also become part of our life now. They will remain, but we will go back to physical spaces in that point, in my view.
Thank you, Nikhil. I think it's a very interesting point you have raised, social capital, the concept of the impact of social capital on human capital. So let me pick Abhishek Bansal's view on that. Considering that the world always thought the gig economy is here and humankind and the mankind has changed, and everybody wants to go backpacking and nobody wants to see multiple other people. What do you think of social capital?
Well, I think it's a very, very valid point and something that we can even replicate and see within our organization. So wherever we know that people have very strong interpersonal skills, and this is generally seen between people who have spent a considerable number of years within the organization. Over there, it was much more easier to get accustomed to the entire work from home ecosystem versus the people probably who would have just joined us within the last few months. And like as an organization, just to give you a quick introduction on what we do. So we are a logistics platform. Okay, so we essentially do logistics movement between point A and point B. And especially in these COVID times when people want to be within the vicinity of their home, the obvious demand for services like us has rapidly increased. So, I mean, within COVID times itself, we have actually ramped up our central and the main operational team by almost 30%. So I would definitely say that hiring people, getting them onboarded into the system, getting them onboarded into the company culture is a very, very difficult task. It is absolutely not easy to imagine us continue doing that over a period of time. And probably as I think Nikhil mentioned, it's a very, very valid point on social capital. I think people where we had developed a lot of social capital over the last few years, getting into the work from home ecosystem was a much more easier effort as compared to getting those new people in and getting them accustomed to the kind of work culture that we have. Apart from that, I think work from home obviously has been a boon for us in terms of, I think I don't know what other people would have felt, but I personally have started feeling that the world is becoming much more accountable to time. There are no more delays. You can't really make an excuse for getting a delay. I mean, I remember various such kind of even panel discussions happening pre-COVID time, And I remember none of the panel discussions ever started on time, and here we are. We are like right on time, not missing a beat over here. So obviously the world is becoming slightly more accountable on time. The spread of information, now that given that we like our meeting rooms are not limiting the size of number of people who can actually sit in those particular meetings, listen to whatever conversations are happening, like that whole aspect of sharing information deliberately within your organization so that everybody knows what is happening, what is not happening. I think we have started seeing a lot more of that happening in a positive manner. And earlier people had, like when there were like physical meetings happening, people always had that excuse, oh, I didn't know that that was happening, or A didn't know that C was happening, because a lot of physical interactions were happening. But now what we're seeing is a lot of interactions get documented very well, they get recorded in a certain manner, and because of the universal constraint in that we are in, that if there are people who are there in like within the same city also, they'll be probably interfacing in the same way that people from three different cities will interface today. So I think it brings a lot more stability in case you have like a multi-city sort of operation, multi-geography operation. So I think all those things have become seamless. But having said that, I think this point of social capital is very, very important, and I don't see that like we can always sustain what we are in today. But we have to find a new normal, which is somewhere between what we were probably 1 year back versus what we are today, and figure out a sweet spot.
Sure. So social capital, human capital, and the hope that mankind won't change and will only go better off. I mean, Pooja, what's your take on that?
So first of all, it's really glad to see so many entrepreneurs together, because we all know we're in the same boat. So all the struggles are pretty much common to everyone. But absolutely right. I think for all the points that we've heard so far, whether it is social capital, human capital, or how things are going to change, I think from a very overall perspective, I think it's been good so far. Now that we are good 6 months into the lockdown, I will say April and May were slightly more tough because it was absolutely a new and a sudden change. But during those 2-3 months, we tried, failed, and finally are at a place where things are now kind of relatively more smooth. So a quick brief about who we are. So basically, Neha and I, we were working at Google. And then we quit around the same time, which was 6-7 years ago. And then we started our digital marketing company, which is what we're running right now. So, and we work with clients across borders. So our sales and client servicing, so to say, has not been affected as much because we were anyways doing that remotely. Only internal operations and, you know, how we will work together. Coming from Google, we did kind of copy paste all our processes and put those here so that we don't have to put our brains into performance management, so many things. But I think now what we are doing is actually we are upgrading some of those things, you know, like performance management, like Nikhil also pointed out, you need someone to, like when your ideas are not being taken or something else, you know, usually some person-to-person connect would be really helpful. So here we are trying to now narrow down on the smallest of efforts also that someone is doing and ensuring that it is well compensated, not just monetarily, but there are many, many ways of doing it. So that upgradation we are doing now. From a very overall perspective, I think for me personally and for the rest of the team also, it's been way more productive than how we were while we were working together, despite all the processes and all the meetings being well, like minimizing a lot of unnecessary meetings also, we would take care of those things. But I think now being able to work from home and you just have to get ready from one room and move to the other, just start your calls right there. You know, you can take a break, just go out, get a fresh cup of coffee or anything. Having fresh cooked home food, because before this we were living on tiffins, which was cooked at 7 in the morning and we were eating at 1 in the afternoon. So I think some of those things are just good. That and of course spending time with family, those things have definitely added up. We've covered those points. So from an overall perspective, I think it's good. It's highly productive, I will say. But yes, there are challenges, and you know, like Abhishek also mentioned, we will come to a middle point. Which will never go back probably to that kind of a normal which was there earlier, even sustainability. So if you see, if this event was to happen in a big 5-star hotel like otherwise it would, imagine the kind of carbon footprint we had, and now suddenly this is like superbly cool. Apart from efficiency and so many other things, I think pollution in Gurgaon has gone down and I'm just loving it totally. So yes, overall I think it's a good change. all we need to do is keep improvising so that we can adjust to it and use it to our benefit.
Sure. Thanks, Pooja. Konark, I have a question from what the other panelists have mentioned. I mean, we have heard points about social impact, social capital, human capital. Does it all mean that we still have improved our human values in terms of empathy? Because having said, while during the COVID, we've also had a huge impact on the economy in terms of negative impact. Your businesses are under stress, your ability to raise capital is under question. And at the same time, you have a large workforce that you need to deal with. That's one part about empathy. The other one is, while all of us are very, very comfortable working from wherever we have been, the point is not everybody has the benefit of space. And it has been, I think, a big, big impact on the families. What's your view?
Yeah, so no, I absolutely agree with what you just said. I think I'm in the minority here in the panel. I think we will go back significantly to a large extent to where we used to be. I do find that this whole work from home thing, as you also rightly just mentioned, is actually we are really dipping into the social capital we had before this started, right? So if you had company-wide networks which you could tap into, we are really making a withdrawal on those deposits. We are not making new deposits, right? So you know, try onboarding a new person in your team right now. I mean, especially try onboarding a junior person in your team right now. Nikhil just mentioned that he's having difficulties getting new talent to onboard. I mean, we are actually a people supply chain. We are a talent factory. We are a software engineer factory. In fact, Zolo is one of our customers. We only deal with entry-level talent. And it's significantly more difficult than it used to be to ramp them up fast. So I think we are in the middle of a big randomized control trial. This is something that humanity could never have done otherwise. So a lot of things will stick, right? But a lot of things will actually also go back significantly. We will find that a lot of things that we were doing earlier were actually also very good. And many of us are planning to go back to some of that, right? So because the argument against offices, Srinath, is really the arguments against cities, right? So what are cities? Cities are essentially a big conglomeration of offices and where people come and work. So, and mankind has been building cities for thousands of years. When the Spanish flu happened in 1920, 1918, we have had gigantic cities being built after that, right? So we should avoid presentism, thinking that what is happening to us today is completely unique and has never happened, and that, you know, we are this special generation which is having to deal with things. People have come before us, dealt with these problems, and there are valuable lessons to be learned, right? I mean, from our business's point of view, actually we have benefited from COVID, because as I said, we are an entry-level supply chain, people supply chain, and our entry-level people are typically much better prepared for a company like Zolo than someone you may hire from campus. Right, so our customers are actually replacing their traditional ways of hiring and actually asking us for more talent. So from a company point of view, actually, you know, from a demand point of view, have significantly benefited from this crisis. But that doesn't take away from the fact that this creates significant supply chain issues for us, and this creates significant onboarding issues for us, and for all the people, right? So I mean, my worry is that we may take this category 5 cyclone as a permanent setting of the ice age, which it is not, right? It is a passing cyclone. Okay, it is very, very strong and it's very destructive, but ultimately it's a passing cyclone. It will go away, and we have to, you know, ultimately we are all entrepreneurs. The reason we are entrepreneurs is because we are actually more hopeful than we are fearful. That's the whole point of being an entrepreneur, right? So we are all hoping, and we have to build, keeping in mind what is coming and not overly worrying about what we are going through today, because this will pass.
Let me quickly do a wrap up with a rapid fire one word question to each of you. Let me go to Pooja. Singh, do you think remote working is a possibility at all with impact, positive impact? Aditya Goel, question is, do you think as an entrepreneur your patience levels have increased in the remote working space?
Oh yes. Well, 12 hours of calls a day, yeah, you have to be really patient for it.
Okay, so the question for Nikhil, being in co-living space as a business, has the quality of life improved for you in this, the last 5 months of lockdown? Abhishek Deshpande, the question for you is, has any of your employees complained that work from home has been overbearing for their families? You have almost like forced them to have office at home. Yes. A question to Abhishek Bansal, your patience levels improved or decreased?
Improved a lot. Yeah, it has improved a lot, yes.
Konark, the last word, one word you would describe this remote working, and one word you would want if you want to change it.
It's a passing fad, some of it will stick.
Thank you. Thank you so much for the wonderful panelists that each of you have been. It was fun and glad to host you. And over to back to the anchor, please.
Thank you, everyone.